Howdy doodly doo! Hello everybody, welcome back. I'm GingerNinja1251, also known as Marlo, and welcome to another Train Simulator review. Today we're going to be looking at the A1 and the A1X Astradley Locomotive Pack by VictoryWorks and Steam Sound Supreme. On screen you can see we're on the Lavender Line. We have two sets of trains, which is two locomotives and a load of coaches. On the left is two locomotives and the coaches from the Early Years Pack, and on the right, two locomotives and coaches from the base pack. We're actually going to be driving the two locomotives on the right. So, all the locomotive liveries are going to be covered at the end of the video. But, to go for a quick rundown, each locomotive is fully customizable in the usual VictoryWorks style, which is absolutely amazing. You get optional coal bunkers. So, the first variant is that one without the coal rails. The next one is with the coal rails. You can have open and closed. You get squared off for the Kent and East Sussex variants, and you also get the Isle of Wight, which is all the way up to the buffer beam. You also get extra optionals, which is tall lamp brackets and short lamp brackets. On Stepney over there is tall lamp brackets, on this one is short lamp brackets. That gives you a choice between four and six discs. So you get four discs on this one and six discs on this one. You also get three styles of chimney. I can't remember if I actually put the right chimney on Stepney and Fenchurch. I'll have to look that back up. You get the Marsh chimney, the Isle of Wight cast chimney, and the original chimney. The Isle of Wight cast chimney is the only one with different sounds, because all the sounds have been recorded off real locomotives. You'll get also additional Isle of Wight modified parts, so Isle of Wight splashers, sandboxes, handrails, lubricators, the Stroudley Southern Whistle, or the Isle of Wight hooder, which I put on Stepney because it sounds so much better. So there's the original whistle, there's the Isle of Wight whistle. You get the Marsh or the Drummond chimney, perfect representation, so that's the Drummond chimney, and that's the original Marsh chimney. Realistic injection control for the advanced variants. You can also, on these locomotives, you get letters. You can choose any name between 3 and 11 letters. So I've just gone with the base because it's boring. I chose Stepney and Fenchurch. They have realistic cab with multiple views, so you can have your head out either side, which is really useful, seeing as how thin the train is compared to the usual locomotives. All of them have custom sound sets recorded from the original locomotives. It's got realistic wheel slip physics and effects, and simulated steam chests for advanced mode. It has fully modelled fireboxes with coal in the firebox, which is pretty nice. And then, so what we'll do is I will show off the coaches. So that's the A1X variants of the locomotives, which are Stepney scripts anyway, I don't know about the others. In the coaches, so for the early years pack, you get the guard coach with third, which is just some benches. Then you also get the third coach, the second class coach, which is basically where they just put carpet over the benches. The third and first composite, which is basically some benches, and the first class with the armrests. Really nicely done. You also get the first class coach, and that's it. This is another livery variant. This is the original tender type. With all that. There we go. You can also get the spark arrestor, it looks very nice. You can also get the spark arrestor on top, which comes with all the locomotives. This is the A1 variant of the locomotives. And it's quite fun to drive. You also... Oh, One thing I didn't mention when I was down there is you can also have the choice between putting the air pump on or not. Now, the difference between the A1s and the M1Xs is they have these big tubes, the big copper tubes with the little bits that stick out the top. This is basically what controls the injectors and the boiler pressure. So basically, these take the exhaust gases and funnel them back through into the side tanks and heat the water up, and then you turn, so you can do that with the condenser control, which I believe is that one, and then you turn on the water, you just turn it straight on, and using a crosshead water feed pump, you should try saying that at 9 o'clock in the morning, with a crosshead water feed pump, that then feeds the water into the boiler, but because it doesn't have steam injectors, you have to heat the tanks up, otherwise when you put the water into the boiler, it completely kills the pressure, because it adds cold water to the hot boiler. So that was the Southern liveried coaches, and these are the LSBCR coaches. These come with the base pack. It's all the same coaches, just in the mahogany London, Brighton, South Coast Railway finish. So, brake and third. Third and first. Third, second, first, and brake and third. And then finally over here, we have two locomotives that represent the later years. I was going to say early years. This is the Kent and East Sussex Railways A1X, which is Bodiam, in Kent and East Sussex Railway Blue. You get, I think it's a choice between Bodiam and Rolvenden, or however you say that, I don't actually know how you say that. With the Kent and East Sussex style tenders, which is actually that one's got, which is the squared off tender. The bit behind the footplate, and then I just put a Mark 1 coach there, so we'll unpause that. I'm going to turn my game audio out a bit more. And then we get, of course, the Great Western Railways variant of the A1s and the A1Xs. You get the unnamed and the named variant. The named variant is number 5, and the unnamed is number 6. The Great Western also comes with... if we just mute that for a sec. It also comes with GWR lamps and the lamp irons, which is very, very useful. That's on the back. And then Bodiam, of course, just has the usual head guards. Right, so we'll let that go off now. Let me turn my game audio down right. And we will get into our train. I'm going to drive Fenchurch all the way up the line. And then I'm going to flip into Stepney's cab and bring it back. So, if we just move that on the way there. Put your 5-1. The difference between Fenchurch... I'm going to use Fenchurch and Stepney as just the difference between the A1s and the A1Xs. The difference between Fenchurch and Stepney is Fenchurch has just the train brake. So that controls the trains and the loco's brakes. However, on the A1X versions, you have that, which is your loco brake, and then you also have your usual normal vacuum brake. In the cab, you have the blower. I'll turn that on a bit. The whistle. You can... So let's do that. You can perform a blow gauge... A water gauge blowdown. Open that. And open that. Using control and space, you get a variant of whistle types, and that's the condenser, which is on at the moment. That's the water. You have to press L to turn it on, and then control and L to lock it on. So control and then control and L. Otherwise, it just goes off. That's the steam for the steam pump. That's the fire door, that's the fire hole. So we've fully modelled. Fire. Two dampers, front and rear, and tail lamp. Well, not tail lamp. The cab light. That's the cylinders. That's for the coal, and that's the handbrake. And over there is the sander. I will probably go through the cab controls when we go into Stepney. So what we'll do is we've got a fair whack of pressure. When you have the condenser on, you should really put the blower on because you don't get a draft. But anyway, let's have a bit of a Barney. Just quickly drive this up and down. There we go. Nice little head code on Fenchurch. Open the beams a bit. I don't know if Stepney might assist as well, you know. Yeah. So, also in the pack, whilst we're doing this, I will shut them, put that down a bit. And open the fire hole. I can do a bit of coal. Do a little bit of coal management whilst we drive on. So, another thing I haven't mentioned is you can also change between the discs and lamps. If you do control and 7, it changes you to lamps. Or if you just do, so back to control and 7, and then you just press H, it will cycle through so you have original lamp setting 1, lamp setting 2, and then lamp setting 3. And lamp setting 3, I just think, puts a red light on the tail. So put a little bit more, shut and blow it down a bit. A little bit of steam going on. So, what also do you get in the pack? Well, you can also, more advanced features are cylinder, drain management, boiler management, and you can also prime the boiler if you put too much water in. It's a very doable thing with the what's it called, the A1s. So what we'll do is we'll turn off that, and immediately the chimney erupts with steam and smoke, and yeah, right, so shut that back. Keep the boil, keep the water thing full. Eventually it will start to fill up. It takes a while. If you watch the shovel, the fire mass, there we go, it stokes up by the shovel full instead of the one, you know, £1 a second or something. So, and you can only shut the fire hole door once the coal doors are shut. So if you try to open that, the fire door's shut, it don't like it. Which is a pretty cool feature. So we'll go back a bit on that. The safety valves are also very smart and monitor themselves. Gradually open every so often. Are we not? Is the boiler not filling up today or something? No? Okay, right, I'll shut that off. Because it has used water. The tanks carry 500 gallons. 5,000 gallons. They carry 500 gallons, so it has used some water. So if we shut the condenser, you'll see that the smoke colour has changed yet again. So from when I was shoveling, it was it was black because the coal was going in, and now it's gone back to white. You've got realistic water gauges. They are affected by the gradient, your acceleration and your speed. You can also do the blowdown tests, as I've shown. The windows do have weather effects, and you can also get cab light effects if you turn on the cab lamp or the open the fire hole door. So I'm going to shut that and we'll slow up now. In the base pack, you also get 4 scenarios. You get four scenarios, 4-3 routes, and in this pack, you get 14 quick drive consists, which consist of. hopefully, if it slows down, these locomotives with short and long trains.